Would you suggest asking for guidance? And if so, who are you asking? What are you asking?
It doesn't matter whom you ask for guidance. It doesn't matter what you ask when you ask for guidance. It is sufficient, totally sufficient, that you have realized that you need to ask. Now you may even go and ask a stone. It doesn't matter. Now you may even go and ask a fish. It doesn't matter. What is important is that your head has bowed down. You have realized that you cannot make it on your own, that you are so limited, that you require the support of something far bigger than yourself, far purer than yourself. Now that something for you could be anything. But the head should be bowed. And that is why in India, distinctions have not been made. It doesn't matter whether you pray to a tree, to a cow, to cow dung, to a river, to the sky, to a cat. Just pray. Just pray. Whatever you get in front of you, kneel down in front of that. It's the kneeling down that is important. Not what you say after kneeling down. Say anything. Sing a song. Recite the alphabet. It doesn't matter. The alphabet will become a prayer. Just say abracadabra. That's the holiest mantra. Kneeling down in front of the lousiest dog you can ever see, say abracadabra, and you are home. That's spirituality. Realizing the limits of our ways. Realizing that this head can point to the heavens only when it first kisses the earth. It must bow down. It doesn't matter what fancy prayer you say. Don't say any prayer. Just remain silent. Or blabber like a six-month-old. What does a six-month-old say? Blah, 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 blah. That's the holiest prayer. God answers such stuff. And He never answers all your organized prayers. The orchestra has been set up. The priest is ready with his fancy clothes, and a time has been appointed, and people are coming, and now the prayer will start. And God says, do. And outside, somebody is whispering to an aunt, abracadabra, and he's home.
There are so many people bowing their heads and, you know, and praying, and but still they don't awaken.
They don't ever bow down their heads. If you decide when to bow down your head, have you really bowed down? If your head is bowed down only at predetermined places, at predetermined times, only in front of predetermined people, then have you bowed down? It is still your own head deciding when to bow down. So the head is still very erect. The head has decided that only in that grand temple, in front of that grand deity or that grand guru will I bow down. So who is winning? Whose will is prevailing? It is the will of the head. How has it bowed down? The bowing down of the head must be very spontaneous. Immediate, without thought. And then it has bowed down. It cannot be an organized activity. You cannot say that every day at 9 a.m. I bow down my head. Hmm? the more it keeps down, the more you rise. Do you get this?
It's beautiful.
Not only to hear, but even more to live. This is very deceptive. It's a monkey, but a cunning monkey. Even in surrendering, it ensures that its own will prevails. I will come and surrender at a time, place of my convenience. Now is that surrender? Surrender is only when it exacts a price from you. Only when it is not convenient, not pleasant, not thought of, not planned.